But now, Top of the Pops, veteran Status Quo, this week at number 5 with Margarita Time.
Even when you are seasoned professionals like Status Quo, no performance can be treated too lightly, especially when the show is going out live. Performing under the influence of alcohol can be a distraction.
You never know what's going to happen when you go out there live.
I had had quite a lot to drink, which we always had when we did Top of the Pops in those days.
One member of the audience thought they would get Francis Rossi's attention by batting a balloon at him.
A real man wouldn't have flinched.
Frighten the life out of you.
Really frighten the life out of me, yes.
Not to be upstaged by this, Rick Parfitt had plans of his own for the finale.
I had told the drummer that I was going to walk into the kit. And I said, don't tell anybody else, just you and I know about it, towards the end of the song. And I mean, everybody's accused me of like having too much to drink and just walking into the kit. First half is true, but it was planned to actually walk into the kit and destroy it, because it was live television, there's nothing they can do about it.
But Rick's antics turned out to be no surprise to the rest of the band.
It went everywhere. I cut my chin. And you knew about it anyway, didn't you?
Yeah, I was there when you told Pete.
Well, I couldn't see him. You see, he was blind drunk.
20 years on and Quo still draw in the crowds and have fans of all ages. If you want to be more than a one-hit wonder, a strong fan base like this is essential.
Yeah, they get their tits out and stuff like that.
Yeah. No, tits, that, it doesn't do me. It does do you, doesn't it, actually?
Not with our fans, it doesn't work somehow.
No matter what your fans look like, they are still the lifeblood of your career.